police officer, correctional officer, and court liaison. Nearly 50 communities will ask voters to raise taxes this spring to support local schools. Stoughton is one of them. And tonight, NBC 15's Chris Pabst takes a look at how one group is trying to convince people to save their schools.
The signs are made, buttons ready, and words of inspiration spoken.
When you walk down that hallway and when you walk and go to vote, think of us.
The march is about to begin.
Save our schools! Save our schools!
All around our state, school districts are asking their property owners for more revenue, and Stoughton is next. The SOS Save Our Schools march is designed to get people to vote yes on April 6th.
This group is marching to River Bluff Middle School, where later today they will hold a rally, and they hope this last-minute effort will be enough to change some hearts.
Stoughton's budget shortfalls are a combination of state-imposed revenue caps and increasing costs. The upcoming referendum will pose two questions. The first raises $8.5 million in program revenue over 4 years, about $200 a year for the average home. The second allows for the borrowing of $7 million for maintenance. If just one referendum doesn't pass, staff will be reduced and activities cut.
We cannot afford to make our education system force it into a lower and lower quality, and then people leave our community.
Just because we're minors, just because we're, you know, not old enough to vote yet, that doesn't mean that we can't make a difference. I know people maybe don't have the money right now, but we're begging you, as students, as people who get this education, please make their education better than you've made mine.
Save our schools!
In Stoughton, Chris Pabst, NBC 15 News.
Davis says a similar vote was held in Stoughton in 2005, and it was defeated by a wide